existence, or even some other people that are having that as part of us. Also founded a project called the People's Kitchen, which is a community food waste kitchen. Started off in Dulston, past the palace, and then spread over to now People's Kitchen, Brixton and Pendry Park. And I also founded the Dulston Cola Company, which is a local manufacturing company making natural soft drinks as a local alternative. So when faced with this question of consumption of food in urban environments, I started thinking, I'm quite interested in permaculture, so I practiced the principles of permaculture and started to think about consumption of food in urban environments from their three principles of earth care, people care, and fair share. And I thought with regard to earth care, with regard to food, we really, really want our food to be organic where possible, and we want to have no carbon emissions associated with food we're consuming. We want it to be as local as possible. With regard to people care, we want healthy food for ourselves and for our friends and family. And that to be as fresh as possible. We also like it to be organic once again. We also want the food to connect us to other individuals in our community. So once again, ideally we'd like for it to be local. And then fair share. So we also like for our food to be fair trade where possible, for the food that we're consuming to be at a fair price for the producer and for the consumers. So I was thinking, how can we create systems that will help us to achieve this within the urban environment? So I started to think about two projects that are currently running at the Russet, one of which is Growing Communities and also Food Assembly, which is also mentioned. So Growing Communities is a fantastic. Has anyone heard of Growing Communities?
Yeah.
They spoke at our first event as well.
There we go. So Growing Communities is they provide a local organic box scheme in Hackney. And we use them for us, for me it's the best salad that I've ever tasted in London. Salad doesn't travel very well, so if you can buy it locally, it's going to taste better. There's quite lots of interesting varieties of salad. They don't even have to dress it, just tastes absolutely amazing. It's beautiful, beautiful stuff. They've also got an impeccable sourcing policy to make sure that whatever they're buying to give into their boxes is coming from as local an area as possible. Preferably from the UK, where they have to, they'll be going and making sure that everything is ship freighted rather than air freighted. If, for instance, they've got bananas in their fruit box for that particular month. But they're facing problems that projects such as Growing Communities, I know that they're finding it quite difficult. Their business model is quite difficult. They rely quite heavily on volunteers. They're finding it very hard to keep their price down. We love supporting Growing Communities, but it's very difficult for us to be buying their salad when it's at such a high price. That's one of the issues with regards to these things that we'd really like to be supporting, but find it difficult to do so. I had similar problems with the Dulston Cola Company, so I started the Dulston Cola Company because I was working at a venue that didn't want to serve Coca-Cola. It was a bit simple. I was saying, sorry, not a service. So I thought a solution to that would be to make our own cola. And so I started looking at recipes and created Dulston Cola. We now produce a cola and a lemonade and a ginger beer. It's bottled over in Hennywick. And just found it very hard. Like, ideally, we wanted to be competing with those big companies that are out there. But it's very, very difficult to be producing a product that's competing on price when you want that product to be natural, to be as organic as possible. Our product uses a lot of natural ingredients rather than essential oils. Coca-Cola is an emulsification of essential oils without natural infusion, which our products are. We just don't benefit from those economies of scale with regard to production and distribution as some of those competitors. So we found that we had to start marketing ourselves as more luxury products rather than everyday products, which is not ideal. One of the other projects that I'd like to talk about is the Food Assembly, which Shane's already mentioned. They're actually operating right now at the Russet. They link local farmers to local consumers. It's a bit like a farmers market, but rather than just coming along to the farmers market, people sign up online and dedicate themselves to buying certain products that the farmer knows that's worth them coming down to the market that particular day rather than coming along and standing at a stall for 8 hours and perhaps selling 5 carrots, which isn't ideal. and the consumer then gets a better price on the products that they're going to be buying, which means that really everyone's winning. It's a great set of solutions of connecting people together to better food for everybody at a better price. It's better for the farmer and for the producer. It's been really successful over Europe. I mean, there's 400 food assemblies over in France now. And there's 3 or 4 that started up in London, and so I urge you to support those kind of local groups. Also think it's important to contextualise urban food consumption with regards to sort of wider structural inequalities that exist within the world of foods. And it's important that we've got local initiatives that support these principles getting together. I recently been part of a project that's called the Healthy Food Partnership. So we're partnering with lots of local organisations. The idea being that collectively we're going to have some more power together in terms of lobbying for better foods, to working on starting up some local projects and campaigning on a local council. Hoping that we're going to provide better healthy food that's as good as possible for the environment and bringing them together. Well, thank you very much.